Mr.
Your life is not on the line. Mine is. And you think that I think this is funny?
I don't think it's funny whatsoever.
So I think, Your Honor, with all due respect, I think you should show some respect.
We're going to take a 5-minute break, and when we come back, the jury's coming out, and you need to call your next witness.
This has got to be one of Daryl Brooks Jr.'s most signature performances of the whole trial. How's it going, everyone? You're watching Everything Else Channel on YouTube, everythingelsechannel.com. Guys, we are over 800 subs. We are trying to get to 1,000 subs. My analytics say that 87% of you watching are not subscribed. There is a little portion either down here or down here. Hover over it, subscribe. All right, guys, so let's talk about this performance here. And it is a performance because Daryl Brooks Jr. says, it's not your life on the line, it's mine. And with all due respect, Your Honor, you should show respect. I mean, to me, and why is Judge Toro standing up? Why? And why is she allowing Daryl Brooks Jr. to stand up? I mean, you know, the whole point of having a judge is for the judge to preside. That's why the judge also, by the way, sits on an elevated platform so the judge doesn't have to stand up. The judge standing up is stating the obvious, right? So I don't understand, you know, and this whole thing with, like, you know, let's take 5 minutes. It's just so classic Judge Toro. It's just like the whole two photos thing where she was about this close to throwing him out with contempt. And she's like, you know, let's walk this back. Let's go have lunch. I mean, it's a weak look. And what about the bailiffs? You know, the bailiffs are there to enforce the judge's orders. The bailiffs look to the judge for direction. The bailiffs see the judge standing up, trying to reassert her authority to this defendant who's standing up, who's barking at her, telling her that she should respect him. And what's her rebuttal? Oh, let's take a 5-minute break. I mean, you know, I got to be honest with you. I give Judge Toro 97. She did a great job. I knock her 3 points for things like this, allowing these little traits in Daryl Brooks Jr. to become habits. The other times, I mean, why is he standing up? Have we ever seen any criminal defendant, even high profile, Bill Cosby, I mean, Charles Manson was one sandwich short of a picnic basket, OJ, anybody, John Gotti, I mean, you know, Carmine Persico, they used to call him the snake on the street. Guy probably has like 300 bodies to his name. He didn't even stand up, much less bark at the judge. I mean, these things don't happen. But why did Judge Toro allow it? And I'm not saying that a high-profile defendant should be able to get away with things that a blue-collar defendant can't. I'm just saying if a high-profile defendant who probably thinks that they own the world because they have so much money and power, if they don't do it, why is Daryl Brooks Jr. doing it? The reality of the matter is, honestly, is that this guy got away with so much. And also, again, why was he standing? You know, what about all the times that he was slouched over the table and the judge was like, are you standing or sitting? When she should have said, sit down. She didn't do it. Why didn't she do it? I mean, you know what I mean?